The new school year is here, so we're going to share some of your back-to-school photos in just a couple of minutes. But first, we're just weeks away from a major local race. We're talking about the St. Pete mayor race. Current mayor Rick Kreisman is term limited, so he can't run again. But there are several people vying for that top spot. 10 Tampa Bay's Miranda Parnell shows you who will be on the ballot.
The St. Pete mayoral race is 2 weeks away, so we caught up with some of the candidates to let them give you a snippet about who they are and what their plans are. First up, Pete Bolin. He's a St. Pete native who says he just wants to serve St. Pete.
I have a full-time job and a career, and I'm not doing this for political ambition. I think that executive experience, that moderate mindset, that small business kind of approach of just being on the ground and being a regular person.
We also spoke with St. Pete native Wingate Newt Newton. He owns his own photography business and spent 8 years as a city council member here, as well as 4 years with the Florida legislature. If elected, he says his top priority, tackling crime.
Murders are up and the opportunity for the young people are down. So we got to focus, number one, first and foremost on crime, because the core responsibility of elected officials is public safety, which is police, fire, EMT, and then infrastructure, sanitation, water, sewage, and garbage, and then the field with stuff.
Then we have Darden Rice. The current city council member was the first openly gay candidate to run for office in Pinellas County back in 2005, and she worked in environmental advocacy for 20 years. She says if elected, she intends to start an office of diversity, equity, and inclusion.
This office will oversee my initiative to deliver a free universal pre-K and our work on providing our citizens with the first 2 years of college.
Now let's go to Ken Welch. The St. Pete native worked for 20 years in corporate technology and says if he's elected, his primary focuses will be smart growth, affordable housing, and neighborhood safety.
We've got to connect young people to opportunity early. It's not just about getting guns off the street. It's changing the mindset that would have a kid pick up a gun in the first place.
We also got in touch with candidate Tori Nelson. Nelson's platforms include supporting after-school magnet programs, affordable housing, and ending homelessness.
Right now, currently, the city has a program, a vision to implement 2,400 affordable multifamily housing to the city. I want to increase that to 34,000 because I think that's the number we need to have an adequate number of affordable housing.
Now, these are just the candidates who we've heard back from, but we have more about all of them at 10tampabay.com. Now, don't forget that election is coming up August 24th.